Hello everyone, my name is Nicky Kirschenmann, Global PLM for the Optical Handhelds and Test Tools, and today I'm going to show you how to successfully upgrade your Smart Pocket V2 unit using Smart Reporter. In order to be able to do that, we always recommend to use the latest version available of Smart Reporter, and you can find the Smart Reporter version by going to updatemyunit.net, scrolling to the bottom of the page, you'll see here's a Smart Reporter section. If you click on that, you get to the page where you can choose to download the latest version available. If you already have another Smart Reporter version installed, make sure that you remove it first before you do the installation of the new version. After you've started Smart Reporter, for the firmware upgrade, we basically have the choice to go to the firmware tab at the top, selecting import. Another window will open where you're asked on how you'd like to do the import, and there are two options, either choosing the file system where you've downloaded your firmware package, or using the VRV server. And to know which versions of firmware available on the VRV server, you can click on preview and see for all the individual types like the broadband power meters or the selective PON power meter and the TruPON tester which version is available. So if we click on VRV server, there's a search, and please make sure that you have an internet connection, that Smart Reporter is looking for the latest, and another window pops up, says that the import has successfully been finished. That's good. Here I have an OP39 already connected via USB but not turned on yet, and you can choose to either keep it switched off, connect the USB cable and then switch it on, or have it switched on already and then connected via USB. It's not a big difference, and you will see that after I'm pressed the on button, that Smart Reporter proposes to carry out a firmware upgrade to the latest version. And with that video, I want you to hear all the sounds, to see everything what's happening on the screen of the unit, as well as what's happening in Smart Reporter, so you can be sure that you're doing everything right. What Smart Reporter is doing is that it's scanning the test results that are available, it's capturing the information of the unit itself, like the serial number and the software version, and another window pops up where it says updating firmware of the unit. I do have a lot of developer versions, that's why it's proposing to carry out the update to this one, which is also shown by the green check mark. That's the latest one. For our video, I'm going to choose this version. So we do have the 03.01.00 installed on the unit, and we want to carry out an update to 03.01.01. This is the latest one available at the moment. You can also click on release notes and get information on what is available with the latest release. If you click on that, another application opens depending on what you've set to be the PDF viewer. In that case, it's in it's my web tool. You see, okay, for the 39 with 03.01.01, these are the things that are included. You can choose to not show the log, but in that case, I highly recommend to have a look at it to understand what is going on. If you're going to show that to customers, it certainly makes more sense to not show the log, because they do not want to see everything with all the details. In that case, I keep it on, so we can talk about what's happening. And depending on which product variant of the Smart Pocket V2 you want to update, there are more or less steps that will be carried out. Alright, so now I'm going to hit update now, and you will hear noises, you will see what's happening on both unit and Smart Reporter. So it's starting the firmware update, and I kindly ask you to be patient on the time, because depending on the version that is installed in the unit, it might take quite a few minutes to get it updated to the latest variant. We always recommend to have the units updated to the latest version available. So in that case, we see that we are about to carry out 8 steps. The first step is to update the primer. In that case, it skips the step because it says it's not necessary to do that because the same version is already installed. The second step is to update the bootloader, which is also skipped because it's already installed. It often depends on, where you start the update from. If it's an older version, you might need to invest more time. If it's a fairly new version, there might be less time that would need to be invested. Here's an extra step to check if everything's still working fine. The third step is to transfer the application. The fourth step is to transfer the templates. Templates are needed to create jobs using Mobile Tech App. The fifth step is an important one for the OP39 because it's transferring the FPGA files to be able to carry out the data analysis. Sixth step is to transferring the Bluetooth file. And there's a moment where SmartReporter asks you to press the on-off button for at least a second. So we have a long press here. Was a sound on, okay, there was an on-off. And SmartReporter continues to progress with the update. After it has been successfully rebooted, it carries on with step 7 of 8. That means after the application has been transferred, it's going to copy the app to the flash. And again, due to the USB connection and that the Smart Pocket V2 is being handled as kind of a USB stick, it would need to be read and written. It may take some time. Just make sure that nobody's pressing anything. You see that the screen is enlightened, right? But you do not see any measurement application at the moment. So in that case, it's good to have the log shown. And in some cases, the USB ports are also restricted. It depends on whether customers or yourself are using PCs or laptops that are handled by the IT department, where they do restrict the USB ports. So you might see that there are some issues with the firmware upgrade itself if these are limited. So just make sure that you contact the IT department or ask us for further support. Now that we've successfully carried out step 7 of 8, the very last step, 8 of 8 on the OP39 is in progress. We do have sometimes the case that we need to update things for the material, like in that case, the Bluetooth chip. And again, depending on the size of the file itself, it may take some time to do that. But just again, be patient. Do not press anything on the unit because now you see that the measurement screen is already visible, right? We are in the PON mode right now. We could potentially press anything, but highly recommend to not press any buttons or remove the USB connection until after the firmware update process has been finished. You see that it's quite slow, but it doesn't mean that it doesn't progress. It's just the way the, just due to the file size. In the case of the OP39, again, we have 8 steps. But we also have to consider that the OP39 is quite packed with a lot of capabilities. So You can also explain to customers if they're asking, why is it taking so long? Why can it be done faster? That the OP39 is very full of necessary files that are needed to be able to carry out successful tests in the field. For the OP35 or OP38, there are less steps required to carry out a firmware upgrade. For the OP37, it's equally little the time that would need to be invested. In that case, again, I keep saying it, but patience is really key here. And it feels that it's taking forever. At the moment, we are at 4 minutes. So we almost completed the task. You see that it's rebooting. And although nothing really happens or you do not hear a sound, just keep in mind that SmartReport is doing stuff. And now we see that at the last row of the lock, a ready appears. That means now the device is ready to be used. We can decide to close this file. You will see that the software version now is shown as 03.01.01 and your OP39 is ready to be used. Thanks for watching and stay updated for further updates.